Are you looking to smash your opponents at the next standard event, poison your foes in Pauper, or empty libraries in Eternal formats? No matter what way you prefer to vanquish the foul, you'll find the tools you need at channelfireball.com. We've got great prices on singles, boosters, sealed boxes, sleeves, and anything else you need to take home the win at your next PTQ or at your kitchen table. Don't get lost in a labyrinth of online shopping. Just try channelfireball.com.
Hello and welcome to another set of Modern Affinity videos. My name is Frank Karsten and today I will be trying out some new cards from Magic Origins. I've been asked quite a bit about Day's Undoing as well as Hangerback Walker in Affinity. So in this first set I will be looking at the prospects of Day's Undoing in the deck. And then in a second set of videos I'll take a look at Hangerback Walker. But first, Day's Undoing. Well, the idea of adding this card to Affinity is of course that this particular deck can empty its hand quite quickly with cards like Mox Opal. It's not all that difficult to enter into a situation where, say on turn 3, you only have one card in hand, your opponent still has 5 or 6. Well, in that case, playing a Day's Undoing means that you get ahead quite a lot on card economy. Of course, Modern is dominated by decks with low curves and combo decks, and many other decks in Modern can empty their hands quickly as well, so that makes it difficult to break the symmetry on Day's Undoing still, but I wanted to try it out in a deck that could really abuse it. Sure, you could add like one or two copies to the sideboard of a regular Affinity deck, and then maybe board it in against slow decks like Jund or Grixis. When you are on the play, I haven't really tried that out much, but I think that might be a reasonable way to go. But I wanted to see how far I would get if I would sculpt the deck around the Day's Undoing. So this is a build that I shared in an earlier article on, well, Day's Undoing. And the deck features some changes to the regular Affinity build. First up, several Aether Vial. Or Aether Vial is, I think, the correct pronunciation. The idea of adding this to the deck is that, well, it gives some additional mana acceleration, which is useful to empty your hands more quickly with Day's Undoing. And the other addition is Disciple of the Vault, where, well, Disciple of the Vault plus Arcbound Ravager is a sweet combo if you can assemble them together. And our regular Affinity decks typically don't play Disciple because, well, on the one hand, it's a colored card. And on the other hand, without a lot of card draw, it's somewhat difficult to assemble a combo consistently enough. And if you draw Disciple without Ravager, it's so-so. But in this deck, with Day's Undoing, all of that changes. It also works well together, right? Aether Vial gives the additional colored mana in order to put all of these disciples in the deck. You can also do some sweet tricks like play Day's Undoing, end the turn, and then on your opponent's turn, hey, tap Aether Vial, put this Arcbound Ravager in play. So that's the idea behind all of these inclusions. I could also see kind of a different build where you put in, say, Frogmite or Mirror Enforcer instead of Aether Vial and Disciple, which would be another way to empty your hand quickly and capitalize more on Day's Undoing. But I wanted to try this first. If you look at the sideboard of the deck, it's, well, a bit random at the moment. I just threw something together, basically. A bunch of cards that I can put in case Day's Undoing isn't good in a particular matchup. And then, well, some usual interactive cards that you see in regular Affinity sideboards. Now, I've played a couple of matches with the deck already, and my initial impression so far is that, well, breaking the symmetry on Day's Undoing is still quite difficult in Modern, even in a deck built around it. Sometimes you just play it and then you have three cards, your opponent has three cards, and, well, it doesn't really get you ahead. So I'm still a bit skeptical about the prospects of Day's Undoing in Modern. Another issue of this deck is that, well, it has so many cards that are good if you have Day's Undoing, like Aether Vial, but which are weak otherwise. So if you don't draw Day's Undoing, the deck is gonna be a bit worse. It's also more difficult to find cards to sideboard out because, well, so much is geared towards maximizing Day's Undoing, which means it's tough to find cards to cut. So, well, there's some issues, but the deck is quite explosive. It can offer some insane starts, and, well, it still has the element of surprise. So, well, why don't you just see for yourself when I play some matches in the next couple of videos. We'll be right back.